your second little remodel.
Yeah.
So these are always a little bit of a challenge because you never know what you're getting into, and most of the time we get into a little bit more than what we initially anticipated. It's things like sometimes there's lead paint, asbestos. We ran into a little bit of that here. Different things with the way that the house has been piped in the electrical run. A lot of these houses, when we get into the remodels, have what's called the tube and pipe configuration, mm-hmm. or tube and post configuration, where actually there's exposed electrical wires running throughout the ceiling, which presents a problem. It's usually okay electrically wise, but one of the things that we do in these houses, and you've probably been told, is we bring them up to a certain level of energy efficiency so that when the people move in, not only is it affordable for them to buy, but it's affordable for them to maintain and to occupy from an electricity standpoint.
You know, the Craftsman style is called Craftsman because you had to be a craftsman in order to build it. And so it's really is a lot of fun to bring these back and deal with some of the architectural nuances that they used to do building houses. Nowadays, you know, everything's slapped up quick. All the Craftsman things, if you were to go to a track home, you know, while it might look nice, they have all these nice looking Craftsman type things on the outside, it's all foam. You know, and if you hit it with a hammer, it's like you could put your cold drinks in it. If you've got maybe a real pinch, you know, they're just styrofoam. So, but we deal with that, bring everything back up to normal wood standards. The other thing that's a little bit different about these houses, as you walk through the remodels and the NSP houses, is they don't conform typically to what we would build a Habitat house, size-wise, number of room-wise. So we do deal with what's in there in some instances. You guys just came from hunt?
Agnes.
Oh, Agnes.
Agnes.
Oh, rat hunt. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah.
Good thing. Well, see, like Agnes, the master bedroom's pretty big. I mean, it's probably 450 square feet altogether, which wouldn't normally happen in a Habitat house. But we deal with what's there. We try to do it as economically feasible as possible and create a nice living environment.